Up till now, we are only able to compute limits from functions which are built from linear factors. Many functions are not that simple. If we have more complicated functions, like powers or roots, we can take the limits inside the function, so take the limit first and then the power of root. Why can we do that and how does that work? Watch this video about the power law and the root law. So, we have the product rule. We saw that one earlier. A limit of a product is a product of the limit if both exist. So you can apply this, of course, if you use g of x equals the same as f of x. So plug in g of x equals f of x. And then we get the limit of f of x times f of x equals limit of f of x squared. So we can basically take the square out. Well, we can generalize that, of course, and do that a number of times, say n times, we do the same trick. So apply the power law n times to the same function f of x, and then we get what is called the power law. Limit x to f function to the power n equals take the limit inside, limit x to a of f of x to the power n. So take limit first and power next. So how does that work? If we have, for example, limit x plus 2 to the power of 3, then we can apply the power law. We can take the limit inside if the limit exists. So we take the limit x to 1 of x plus 2 first and then to the power of 3. Well, if you take the limit x to 1 of x plus 2, that limit exists, use the sum rule or whatever, you get 1 plus 3 equals 3, and then to the power of 3 equals 3 to the power of 3 equals 27. And a special case, of course, of this power law is if you take as your f of x a function x, then you know the limit x to a of x to the power n is to take the limit in x to a of x to the power n, and limit x to a of x, that was one of our two basic limits, that's just x to the power n, so that gives us a to the power n. So an example of that, if you have, for example, limit x to 2 of the function x cubed, can take the limit inside, first take the limit, then the cube, so limit x to 2 of x cubed, which gives you a 2 cubed equals 8. So now we have the power law. Well, sort of inverse of the power law is the root law, because roots are the inverses of powers. So how does that work? What if we want to take the limit of a square root, for example? So suppose this limit x to a of the square root of a function f equals l, suppose this limit exists. Then we can do l times l equals l squared, and l times l equals the limit times the same limit. So we have this limit twice and we multiply them with each other. And then you have a limit which exists times a limit which exists, and it means that we can use now the product rule, so like an inverse product rule. Instead of taking limit of the first one times limit of the second one, we can take the limit of the product. So that's what we do over here. Take the limit of the product of square root of f times square root of f. Well, the product square root of f times square root of f is just f. So that's the limit x to a. And then on this final equality, we take square roots. So the square root of limit x to a equals the square root of l squared equals l. So the L equals the square root of the limit x to a of f, and this L was also equal to the limit x to a of the square root of f. So you see you can take the square root, if you like, here inside the limit. That's the root law, similar to the power law. So how do you computations with that? General formulation, limit x to a of f of x to the power 1 over n, you can take the limit inside, equals, take the limit first and then the nth root. So if you have, for example, the function f of x equals x plus 6 to the power 1 half, and want to take the limit x to 3, you can take the limit inside, so that's the limit x to 3 of x plus 6 to the power 1 half. Well, the limit inside is easy, it's just 3 plus 6 equals 9, equals 9 to the power 1 half equals 3. And a special case, again, similar to the power law, what happens if you take the limit x to a of x to the power 1 over n, so if you take f of x equals x, again you can take in the limit, so you take the limit inside, you take the limit x to a of x to the power 1 over n, limit x to a of x equals a, so that yields a to the power 1 over n. So, an example of the special case, limit x to 8 of x to the power 1 over 3, you can take the limit in, limit x to 8 of x to the power 1 over 3, limit x to 8 of x equals just 8 to the power 1 over 3 equals 2. And there you go. So, that is the root rule and some examples of how you can apply them.